Good morning. Happy Easter. Welcome to the Unitarian Universalist Congregation of Danbury. As our first order of business, let's please silence our cell phones if we haven't already done so. My name is Samantha McCoy, and I signed the membership book here in December 2003, I believe it was. Once I was fully engaged here, I started participating a good deal in religious education as a teacher, and then serving on the RE ministry team and even chairing that team for a while. I'm currently finishing a three-year stint with the Board of Trustees, and I'm currently your secretary of our board. Because it is the third Sunday of the month, we've been having board members do the welcomes on those days. So here I am for April. And after the service, please feel free to approach me to chat if there's anything you'd like to find out about what the board's working on or questions. I'll also be available electronically on Zoom for those at home. The Unitarian Universalist Congregation of Danbury has been gathering together for 200 years. And as we work to build a more just world, we respectfully acknowledge that our physical building is on the traditional land of the Paugusset people. I'm so glad that you're able to join us this morning, because you are an essential part of our celebration today. Whether today is your first, 100th, or even 1,000th Sunday in our midst, in person or online, we're stronger because you are with us. If you're new to our community and joining us online, we invite you to introduce yourself and where you're connecting from in the chat box as you're comfortable. At the conclusion of today's service, you'll have a chance to participate in a breakout group for individual connections and deeper check-ins. If you're new here and here in person, please fill out a visitor card at the table near the exit before you leave today. We are one people of many beliefs, many origins, sexualities, and genders. We're all growing, all learning, all loved. Just as you are welcome here. In terms of our announcements for today, there are two things I'll make note of. And one is the fact that we have been doing a fundraiser for the International Rescue Committee for Ukraine. And we want to thank, first of all, Marianne Kula for helping to organize that and prod us in the right direction with that effort. And we are happy to announce that we raised $1,745 with that effort. And there are ongoing fundraisers, so please stay tuned for those as well. We also want to point out that next Sunday after the service, we will be having our Care and Share Fair. And you can see on the screen our lovely Care Bear reminding us to take part. There will be cookies, there will be pizza, gluten-free options. You'll get a passport that you can get stamped by visiting the fair. So we hope you'll all join us next Sunday for that. And now Reverend Kathleen has an announcement to add.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning to those joining us through Zoom. I just want to see hands as to how many people have already decided the two areas of congregational life that they are going to serve in next year. In other words, you know you're going to do the choir and you're going to help with hospitality, or you know you're going to serve on the membership team and the Sunday services team. How many have already chosen the two places? Okay, some. And yet there's still a lot of time for those of you who haven't decided which two places, notice I'm saying two places, that you are going to give of your time and your talent. And of course, the Care and Share Fair next Sunday after the service is going to be a great way to find out what are all these different ministries and teams that are going on. What do they do? What kind of help do they need? Does my passion and my talent meet those needs? And that's where we hope you'll find a fit. But those of you, I have a special request for those of you who are members, who've been a member 2 years or longer. How many people here have been a member of this congregation for 2 years or longer? Right, quite a few. I'd like for you to spend this week thinking about two particular places that this congregation needs you. You might have just dismissed it before, but I'm asking you to please give consideration this week, and that is to our nominating committee and our board of trustees. These are extremely important positions in this congregation that we need to be able to carry on the business of the congregation. And Yvonne, would you mind just raising your hand? Yvonne is on the nominating committee now, and Jane Leff, would you raise your hand? So if you want to know what does that mean, what does that require, would you speak to one of them and or Margaret Henderson, one of our co-presidents of the Board of Trustees, speak to them, at least find out what that means. And I know some have been here so long and you have served in so many capacities. It's kind of been there, done that. Maybe even some of you who are tuning in through Zoom. But we need your historical memory of the congregation. We need your understanding of the culture of the congregation in these positions, nominating and our Board of Trustees. So I ask you to consider that. And then when you come next Sunday, everybody, enjoy the Care and Share Fair and find out those two places where you're going to serve. Again, we welcome you to this service of the Unitarian Universalist Congregation of Danbury. Let's rise in body or spirit as you are able and join in our hymn of welcome. It's Bring Out the Festal Bread. I've got my tambourine ready. The words will be there. So if at any time you feel like you'd like to just move maybe a little bit instead of being frozen to the hymn book, put it down. You can look at the words here and at home. We know you're going to be tambourining and dancing around, but let's sing in celebration. Bring out the festal bread.
Shout with the slaves who fled and sing song of freedom. What modern pharaohs live in arrogance crowned? Who shall be sentenced? Folly unbounded. Bring out the festal bread and sing songs of freedom. Shout with the slaves who fled and sing song of freedom. Chains still their heart break, their days are not finished. Who shall be sent to chastise? Bring out the festal bread and sing songs of freedom. Shout with the slaves who fled and sing songs of freedom. Fill the prison, find each brother and sister. Still do the plagues affect us red as the river. Bring out the festal bread and sing songs of freedom. Shout with the slaves who fled and sing songs of freedom. Won't we our journey and get justice? Stand, Sister Miriam, and help us to birth it. Bring out the festal bread and sing songs of freedom. Shout with the slaves who fled and sing songs of freedom. Oh, people, lift your heads and look to the mountains. Bushes of flame still call us, rocks still gush fountains. Bring out the festal bread.
This morning's opening words are from a former minister of this congregation, Barbara Peskin. Gloria!
The tenacity of earth and its creatures.
Kyrie eleison.
These children who will go on to save what we cannot.
Baruch atah Adonai.
The ordinary tenacity of plants and of people.
The center of the universe, which is everywhere, not the least place in the human heart.
Alleluia.
Love that survives anger and winter and despair and sorrow and even death.
Shalom.
Love that persists.
Namiho renge kio.
calm that is the seed in the dark.
Amen.
For endings that are beginnings, for beginnings that are endings.
Alleluia.
For the circle, the spiral, the web.
The egg, the orbit, the center, the seed, the flower, the fruit.
The opening, the death, the release, the seed.
Amen.
We are going on.
Amen.
It is going on.
Amen.
Blessed be. Our service coordinator, Rick Cousins, will come and light the chalice for us and lead us in our chalice lighting words.
Please join me in reciting the words in your order of service. Love is the spirit of this congregation, and justice is its light. This is our covenant, to dwell together in peace, to seek and speak the truth in love, to help one another and celebrate life.
It is so good to be together. Let's say the children's affirmation, the words for which are on the screen. We are Unitarian Universalists. We are people with open minds, loving hearts, and helping hands. We care for the earth and each other.
Sierra Marie.
Yes, Reverend Kathleen.
Have you seen our stewardship lately?
Look. Oh my goodness. Look at that.
At all the hands on there.
I think I saw even more hands going on there recently.
Yes, because it's many hands and one community. It takes all these hands. It takes even more. But these are all hands of people in this congregation, either from years past or right now, who have already made their pledge to our stewardship campaign. We've got a lot of hands there. Doesn't it look fantastic? And we have our compass there to keep our direction.
But you know, there's something missing.
What?
I think this ship needs an identity. I think there's something that we need to mark the identity of this ship.
Oh.
Ethan, bring out the flag.
A flag, of course. Why didn't I think of that? Thank you, Ethan. Yes, I see what you mean, Sierra Marie. Now everyone will know this is the stewardship of the Unitarian Universalist Congregation of Danbury. And we thank all of the hands who are on the ship now and all of the hands who are ready to make their pledge. We have one more week in this campaign.
I cannot wait to see more hands go on there.
Thank you, Sierra Marie. We have so much to celebrate and be joyful about. And we bring our whole selves when we come into this community, whether we are in person or we're online. We bring those joys, we bring those celebrations, and we bring our heavy hearts too. For all of those milestones held in our hearts, not quite ready to share aloud, we honor those. And I invite you into a time of silence. As Deb said, sometimes it's just so refreshing to be in a moment of quiet. It doesn't mean there won't be some ruffling of papers. There might be a cough or a sneeze. But those are sacred sounds in this time. It's the sound of us being together. But let's hold the grief, the joy, the concern, the relief. Let's share all of that together. Hold it in this moment of silence.
Let us continue to remember the people of Ukraine and all of those around the world suffering violence and war, sometimes even in our own lives. We acknowledge and we work together to not only create peace, but to be peace. Continuing in this spirit of reflection, let us sing together, staying seated, Spirit of Life. Today's reading is from Spring Reading in Quest for Meaning. Why is this time of year different from other times? This is the time when we remember that death is a natural part of life on earth, and that all living things renew themselves over and over, year after year after year. We can have faith that this will happen this year too. This is the time we begin to see those tiny little buds on the trees. And they've been looking like piles of twigs all winter. This is the time we begin to see the grass green again. We feel the strength of the sun again. We enjoy the light of this season. This is the time when Passover and Easter are celebrated. It is the time of Easter bunnies and painted and decorated eggs. This is also the time of our sacred storytelling. Thus ends the reading.
Please join me now in reading the words from our order of service to accept today's offering. In the spirit of compassion and service, we dedicate these, our offerings.
If I close my eyes, I can see myself on an Easter morning as a little girl in my brand new Easter outfit. It's a white dress and it has little tiny yellow flowers on the collar and has a big white satin bow in the back. I also have a white hat, gloves, lacy white socks, a new pocketbook, and new shiny patent leather shoes. Not black ones. Oh, no. Not white ones. No, no. Yellow. Yellow, the color of butter. I can smell the lilies that decorate the altar and my great-grandma's lavender dress as we sit on the hard wooden pew of her tiny, tiny church in rural Oklahoma. She lets me look in her pocketbook, and it is not called a purse, it is a pocketbook. She lets me look in there very quietly for a piece of gum, but I'm only allowed half a stick. I'm not sure why. And it's always Wrigley's Double Mint. I see a lot of heads shaking. Was that like a grandma gum or something? And I try so hard to sit still as I can while the preacher delivers his Easter sermon. This is a little Baptist church. It's the same sacred story from the same sacred text every Easter, so I already know it well. But as I began to have children of my own, I wanted to make Easter memories that went beyond the tiny rural church of my childhood, because I found myself seeking sacred stories from other sacred texts and finding there were so many. There's an abundance of sacred stories that can teach us, that can inspire us, that can comfort us. In fact, this year, for the first time in 30 years, I think actually maybe 33 years, Ramadan, Passover, and Easter all overlap. It's amazing. The sacred stories of those religious traditions being observed and celebrated at the same time by Muslims and Jews and Christians all over the world. It's a beautiful thing. And there are many more sacred stories being told in this season of spring, because sacred stories really reveal what is divine in our lives. So this morning, you will hear some very brief stories and pieces of sacred text. They will come from some various religious traditions. They will come from our own hymn book, a sacred text to our community. You will even hear a brief story from a new member of this congregation. And after each story, so I want you to listen to it, to find the sacredness in it. And then afterwards, Jerry is going to play a congregational sung response. He's going to play it through. The words will be on the screen, and then we will sing that short response through twice after each story. So what is a sacred story? Moses and the escape from Egypt, Krishna and Arjuna on the battlefield, Jesus feeding the 5,000, first woman, and coyote. So would the first reader please come forward?
What is a sacred story? Passover remembered, from Alla Renee Bozarth.
Pack nothing. Bring only your determination to serve and your willingness to be free. Don't wait for the bread to rise. Take nourishment for the journey, but eat standing. Be ready to move at a moment's notice. Do not hesitate to leave your old ways behind. Fear, silence, submission. Only surrender to the need of the time, to love justice and walk humbly with your God. Sing songs as you go and hold close together. You may at times grow confused and lose your way. Keep telling the story. Make maps as you go, remembering the way back from before you were born. It is the first of many beginnings, your paschal tide. Remain true to this mystery. Pass on the whole story. Do not go back. I am with you now, and I am waiting for you.
What is the story of Passover?
It is a story of the Jewish people able to escape their slavery in Egypt, led by a Hebrew man named Moses. After many years of wandering, they finally came to a promised land of their own. At the time of Passover, Jewish people all over the world celebrate their freedom with a Seder dinner.
We need stories of our passions, our desire, our anger, our grief, permission to see anger as part of our power. And to convert it into creative energy is part of the sacred story. Let's respond. What is a sacred story? Easter morning from Mark 16.
On the first day of the week, at early dawn, they came to the tomb, saying, "Who will roll away the stone from the entrance to the tomb?" They looked up and saw that the stone had already been rolled back, and on the right, they saw a young man. They were alarmed, but the man said to them, "Why do you seek the living among the dead?" So they went out and fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them.
What is the story of Easter?
What is the story of Easter?
It is the story of a man named Jesus. Many years after the Hebrews escaped Egypt during the Roman Empire, Jesus was a Jew who talked about love, peace, and respect for every person. Some Roman leaders who were afraid he would start a rebellion, and some Jewish leaders were afraid he would change their religion. Jesus was arrested and put to death. Today, the teachings of Jesus live on, and Christians all over the world celebrate Easter in his memory.
We need stories of dark nights of the soul, and we need stories of resurrection. When our hearts break, the cosmos opens up. Let us respond.
I know this know my soul will unfurl its wings. I know this rose will open. I know this rose will open. I know my fear will burn away. I know my soul will unfurl its wings. I know this rose will open.
What is a sacred story? The Sacred Hoop from Black Elk.
Then I was standing on the highest mountain of them all, and round beneath me was the whole hoop of the world. And while I stood there, I saw more than I can tell, and I understood more than I saw. For I was seeing in the sacred manner the shape of all things of the spirit, and the shapes as they must live together like one being. And I saw that the sacred hoop of my people was one of many hoops that make one circle, wide as daylight and starlight. And in the center grew one mighty flowering tree to shelter all the children of one mother and one father. And I saw that it was holy.
What is the story of baby animals, bunnies, colored eggs, and the earth welcoming spring flowers and green grass?
This is the oldest story of all. Ancient people waited each year for spring to return. They waited for signs of new life. They saw eggs as a symbol of new life, and they noticed that rabbits had large and frequent families. They watch eagerly for the first green shoots of spring, which meant fresh food for their own families. Many people in all times and places have decorated eggs for spring celebrations. Baby animals, bunnies, flowers, and green growing things are all symbols of new life.
We need stories of ancient beauty, symbolism, and relationship with the earth. Let us respond. What is your sacred story? I challenged this congregation, members, friends, and visitors to consider your "This I Believe" statement, your credo. And this morning we will hear via video the credo of new member Randy Becker, a sacred story indeed.
My credo has been shaped by so much. Deep roots planted in rich universalist soil. A solid trunk of family. Spreading branches always reaching for the skies of possibility in many directions. And leaves seeking. Always seeking sources of light and life. The skies above me, however, have been mixed clouds and sun. And I have been nourished by both. A bout of cancer nearly 50 years ago. The loss of a son soon after birth, a divorce, the death of a 20-year-old daughter through the actions of a drunk driver, the recent death of my wife, but also the many rewarding and fulfilling times in ministry, exploration of diverse world cultures, four wonderful daughters, 25 years of afterlife communications, and finally meeting Jane last summer on a magical Unitarian Universalist island. That mix of the wrenching and the enhancing scripted what I say when I say, I believe. I believe I'm more than my body, but I can't completely say what or how, and that something else has been and always will be beyond this one time around the wheel of existence. I believe that I've had the opportunity to live and to enjoy in many existences, not just now, but before and after, providing opportunities to learn and then remember what is the essence of my being. You know, most people seem to learn much, but it's the same things over and over again because they do not remember. I believe that the existence of all else is shaping me, but that I am also shaping all else. All that is cannot exist without me or you in it, and none of us can exist separate from all that is. No name, no description, no ritual can adequately contain or even portray all that is, but every attempt to do so manifests a portion of that inclusive whole. Throughout my many existences, I've come to learn and hopefully remember some simple things. First, that there is preponderance, even if ever so slightly more, of being as opposed to non-being. So my being tends toward the whole, the positive, the good. And there can be meaning on the other side of anything. I can speak from personal experience of profound losses and trials. Meaning is not necessarily stopped because of experience. And finally, the key to all of it, I can make it if I focus on connections, not on differences. Thank you.
We need stories of personal truths, discovered and claimed, sharing our values, our identity, our faith in community. That is what enriches all of our lives. Let us respond. Is sacred. It is your truth. There are many symbols throughout the world that are used to represent truth, the Dharma wheel. Many know this holds deep significance in Buddhist culture. In fact, the word Dharma means truth in Sanskrit. And it makes sense, if I can find my tiny little mirror, it makes sense why mirrors would be considered a symbol of truth. They show what's really there. They're used in a lot of poetry and works of art and literature to symbolize truth. I'm sure, well, I hope most of us, especially the children or those of us who are children at heart, remember the example of Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. When the mirror was asked, who is the fairest of them all? It was asked because the mirror tells the truth. Our flaming chalice represents and symbolizes our quest for truth. And a heart represents truth because it is the ultimate symbol of love. This morning, we are going to be using hearts and mirrors as our symbols of our sacred stories, our truths. And who is going to be helping us today, Sierra Marie?
Ethan is going to be helping
us. Ethan, would you come and help hold one of the baskets, and Sierra Marie will hold the other with these symbols of mirrors and hearts. We are going to invite you to come
forward on either side to the basket on your side, one row at a time, while Jerry plays music underneath. But I ask you to come quietly and in the spirit of reflecting on your own sacred story, your own truth. And as you approach the basket, you can choose a mirror or a heart. And I am going to open the book that is on the chancel table so that it may collect all of our symbols of our sacred stories in this community. If you wish, and those of you online, what I want to invite you to do is to envision your symbol. What would your symbol of truth, your sacred story be? And envision yourself contributing to the open book here on our chancel table. And as each of you takes one and puts it into the book, whether you are on this side, Sierra Marie will just say quietly, the sacred story of, and I invite you to just say your name. It is not for everyone to hear, it is for you to hear, for you to be reminded of the sacredness of your life's story. So come, let us gather the bounty of sacred stories in this community. Thank you.
Thank you for sharing your sacred story with each of us here. The stories have been gathered.
Sacred, everyone.
And may it be so.
As we approach the end of our service, please join me in reading from your order of service, the chalice extinguishing. We extinguish this flame, but not the light of truth, the warmth of community, or the fire of commitment. These we carry in our hearts and out into the world until we are together again. Please join me now in the hymn of celebration number 61 in your hymnal.
What is a sacred story?
It is those told by the world's religions.
It is those told through the history of Unitarian Universalism.
It is your story.
My story.
The stories of friends and the stories of strangers.
Let us continue to tell our stories and listen to the sacred stories around us.
Inspiring one another to live our lives with dignity,
love,
and courage
today and for all the days to come. Shalom. Salam. Amen. Blessed be to each and all here and throughout the world. Namaste.
Now time for us to move into our post-service breakout groups. that would be happening for the people in the Zoom session. We have about 15 minutes to discuss any topics today or spend the time growing to know somebody that you don't know so well and making time for them. After 15 minutes, the breakout groups will close, and that will conclude our Sunday service for today. For those of us in the fellowship hall here with me, feel free to break up into groups and enjoy each other's company. Thank you.
And we do have coffee today, and we have cookies, so we want to be sure to thank Inga and Suzanne for providing that conviviality for us today. And there will be, Sierra Marie, there will be an egg hunt,
yes,
for our children, so we'll want to encourage them outside. So have something to nibble on, have some coffee, share with one another,